If you like to talk to tomatoes,
if a squash can make you smile, if you like to waltz with potatoes, up and down the produce aisle,
have we got a show for you.
Hi there, this is Larry the Cucumber. On behalf of Bob the Tomato and all my veggie friends, welcome to this special episode of Veggie Tales, brought to you by Chick-fil-A. We hope you enjoy the story, the silly songs, and especially the very important lesson. So listen closely, and now, get ready for the story of Larry Boy and the Bad Apple.
It's time for Veggie Tales.
Hi, kids. Welcome to VeggieTales. I'm Bob the Tomato.
And I'm Larry Boy.
And I'm Alfred, Larry Boy's faithful butler. And we're here to answer your questions. Today we have a text message from Libby.
A text message?
It's the latest thing. Cool, huh?
Our text message comes from Libby Forcucci from Stockbridge, Massachusetts.
And Libby writes, "Dear Larry Boy, I just love watching you help people escape fibs and rumors. But I've got something in my house I just can't escape. And now, I need your help. I really love playing video games. Sometimes all I can think about is playing, even when I'm supposed to be doing my homework or cleaning up my room. I'll look over to that controller, and I can't help picking it up and playing. What should I do?"
It sounds like you're having a problem with temptation.
Temptation? What's that?
Well, simply put, temptation is the desire to have or do something that you know you should avoid, or the act of influencing by exciting hope.
He means it's when you want to do something that you probably shouldn't do.
And it just so happens that we have prepared a story of adventure and mayhem that addresses this self-same dilemma.
That means we have an exciting show that just might help you.
And now, here's our story for today. Larry Boy and the Bad Apple.
This is Petunia Rhubarb, reporting from Bumbleyburg Park, where preparations are underway for the city's gala tricentennial celebration. But as the city gets ready to celebrate its 300th birthday, something very odd has been discovered which has authorities concerned. The statue of Bumbleyburg's founder, Obadiah Bumbley, has been mysteriously wrapped in what appears to be a giant spider web. And one such concerned authority would be none other than the mayor of Bumbleyburg herself, Mayor Blueberry.
Oh, hello. I was not expecting you.
Mayor Blueberry, do you expect this recent vandalism to have an impact on the upcoming celebration?
Heavens, no. Everything is organized and well under control. I'm not letting a few silly cobwebs get in the way of our 300th birthday.
Well under control, indeed. Once I'm finished with them, I'll be the one in control. Oh, Curly, you've returned. Come, tell me what you've learned.
Yeah, I love this World Wide Web thing you got going. Very high tech.
Oh, for the moment, it's only my Bumbleyburg wide web. But be patient. First Bumbleyburg, then the world.
So, what you got? Paralyzer beams, magnetic webbing, an army of little radioactive robot spiders?
Silly worm, that's not the way I operate. I'm temptation. I'll simply divide and conquer. No one can stand up to me on their own.
Oh, yeah, right. Very smooth.
Tell me then, what have you scouted out for me? Who's in charge? Which pillars need removal?
Every town needs three key elements to operate. One, organization. You got Mayor Blueberry, the city's duly elected leader. She runs the city, keeps everything moving like a well-oiled machine.
And her weakness?
Vanity. She wants to be beautiful.
Perfect.
Two, communication. Meet Petunia Rhubarb, television news reporter. Bumbleyburg looks to her to find out what's going on.
Well, I've got news for her. What's her secret weakness?
Video games. She's good at them, too. and she'd be happy to play them all day long.
Excellent. I think I might be able to arrange something.
Tree protection. And that comes courtesy of Larry Boy, superhero.
There's nothing there.
Actually, I'm still kind of working on that one, boss.
Well, then kind of work a little harder. I need to know about their defender if we want to take him out. Meanwhile, I believe I'll pay a visit to Her Honor the Mayor. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Just a pretty little apple with some time to spare. Open up.
Apple who?
A harmless little kitty with her eye on you. Open up that door and let me in. Don't you worry about those hairs on your chinny chin chin. I'm not preaching moderation. Knock, knock.
What's your name?
Temptation.
Oh no!
Temptation!
Look out!
Temptation!
Not now, Jean-Claude. I'm extremely busy. I said, who let you in?
I was hoping you would.
Look, I'm very busy right now. I've got a million things to organize for the celebration.
Why, that's exactly why I'm here. With everything you have to worry about, I thought you might need a little help with your outfit for the occasion. I'm a seamstress, you might say.
What a fabulous cape.
Look at those eyes and that lovely purple-blue complexion. With a little work, you could be a knockout.
For sure, please. I'm not one of those vain blueberries who only thinks of her appearance. A knockout? Do you really think?
Absolutely.
Please come in.
And you know, there's no harm in wanting to look your best. After all, you represent all of Bumblyburg. You owe it to your citizens to appear fabulous at all times.
What a marvelous dress. I love the color. Is that crimson?
It's more of a scarlet. Knock, knock.
What's your name?
Temptation.
Oh, no.
Temptation.
Look out!
Temptation!
Hold on, Jerry. I'll be right with you.
Okay, let's do some reporting. Oh, can I help you?
I hope so. Sometimes it's just so hard to help yourself.
Huh?
I have something you might be interested in.
I'm sorry, but I'm on a deadline. Huge breaking story, Trice and...
Oh, bless your heart. You are the busy one. Don't you ever relax?
Well, yeah. I play my handy pod.
What if I told you I have the one and only test version of Handy Pod Advanced?
Handy Pod Advanced?
Maybe I could come in and give you a demonstration?
I don't know. I need to find out what's going on with the statue and who's responsible and...
With Laser Cycle 4000.
Laser Cycle 4000? Come on in.
I'd love to.
This is advanced. It looks like you can walk right in.
Oh, but you can. Go ahead. Walk right in. Have fun.
Oh, boy. Petunia's walked into the Bad Apple's web of temptation and can't escape its control. How will she get out? Let's see what happens next.
No news is good news. Oh, Uncle Ephraim, you'd be so proud. Now the only force standing between me and my conquest of Bumblyburg is Larry Boy.
Not to worry, boss. I got the goods on him and that brainy butler of his. Two words: bananas and chocolate.
Mmm, delicious.
Master Larry, this is exceedingly interesting. What? Apparently, these mysterious webs are nothing new. It seems they've plagued the city of Bumblyburg in the past.
When? How? Why?
Unfortunately, my computer database doesn't contain such old information. I believe I'll have to make a trip to the Bumblyburg Historical Society to find out more.
Oh, no. I've got to move fast.
I'll be back shortly, Master Larry. Meanwhile, I trust you won't give in to your temptation while I'm gone.
Don't worry, Alfred. I'm stronger than temptation. I'm a superhero. Who is it?
Hello? Alfred said someone named Larry Boy might need some assistance.
Well, you can tell Alfred that Larry Boy's a superhero and he doesn't need any help.
Oh, I see. Well, let me leave my card with you, just in case. Now, where did I put those?
Maybe it's under the chocolate.
Did you say chocolate?
Yeah, right here, under the chocolate.
Well, I guess it won't hurt to have the opinion of another trainer. Wait. You need security clearance.
Oh, well, I,
promise not to tell anybody about my secret cave?
Cross my heart.
All clear. Come on in. I'll be right... Larry Boy will be right up.
I thought you'd never ask.
Nearly 300 years ago, a small band of valiant vegetables would embark on a ship they called the Cauliflower to settle an unknown land.
Led by the fearless Obadiah Bumbley, they soon began establishing a primitive settlement in the wilderness of the New World.
Today, we give thanks for our safe arrival on these beautiful and bountiful shores. Obadiah Bumbley.
But it wasn't long before it became clear that something was rotten in the new settlement.
Dearest Catherine, I am finding myself irresistibly drawn to a fascinating new establishment in town. It is called Appley's Funhouse. And boy, does it look like fun! Abraham Roberts.
Soon, chaos would reign in their little community.
The cause of all this chaos was Ephraim Appley, a bad apple who had come over on the Cauliflower determined to take over the tiny town by distracting them with play. His plan was to enslave the community with non-stop fun. It was only the timely arrival of Obadiah Bumbley that saved the little community from ruin.
Ephraim Appley, thou art a scourge upon the fair face of Bumbleyburg. Obadiah Bumbley.
Oh, brother Obadiah, thou art so uptight. Prithee, let the brethren play at the little checkers. Ephraim Appley.
I have naught against a bit of harmless amusement, brother Ephraim. It is well and good to play as thou checkers on occasion. Citizens of Bumbleyburg, I beseech ye, let us turn our backs on this rotten apple and his house of overindulgence. Thou hast tried to lead us into temptation, brother Ephraim, but we shall not follow thee. Obadiah Bumbley.
Oh, yeah? Says who?
Say we.
Okay,
get please.
Here.
Be gone.
Get away.
Gone.
Be gone.
Ephraim Appley.
Please.
And thus, Ephraim Appley and his lineage would be forced from Bumbleyburg, defeated in his plot to rule the little village.
Oh, my. That apple. Master Larry? What's happened to you? Oh, no. You've fallen into a web of chocolate temptation.
Now, isn't that an awful shame?
You! You're Appley! How did you get in here?
Why, your superhero friend let me in, of course.
Well, if he'd known what I know, he certainly never would have.
And that's what they all say. But they always let me in.
I know all about you.
And, of course, I know all about you, too, Alfred.
What? What are you doing?
Alfred, poor Alfred. You've been working so hard doing all that tedious research in the library. Don't you think you deserve a little harmless amusement?
Good evening, and welcome once again to my Bananarama extravaganza.
Oh, no, you don't. I'm not going to fall.
Whoopsie daisy.
That gets me every time.
Yes, the banana is a comic genius. And, of course, only the smartest, most tasteful people can appreciate his work.
Indeed, ma'am. I've often harbored that very thought myself.
Ta-ta, boys. I've got a big surprise for Bumbleyburg. Now, great Uncle Ephraim, our time has come. Soon I'll control this town with that silly superhero and his butler out of the way. We need to move fast. And now to launch the final phase of my brilliant scheme.
Bumbly Bird will be ours! Yours, I mean! Everyone will be in your power!
That's better. Wait till they see what I've got in store for them. I'll spin a monument to temptation so alluring that no citizen of Bumblyburg will be able to resist. All will enter, but none will ever come out.
Right up, come one, come all. You don't want to miss out on this fun and exciting opportunity. And whoopsie doozy, I slipped on my own heel. Hurry, folks, come on down to Appley's Funhouse 2. That's right, Appley's Funhouse 2.
Master Larry, you must listen. Bumblyburg is in terrible danger. They are being led into temptation.
Chocolate.
Larry boy, Bumblyburg needs a hero.
Hero? I am that. I am that hero!
Oh no! I've fallen into a web of chocolate temptation! Alfred, I can't get out of this mess by myself. I need your help.
As do I, Master Letty. Throw me a line!
I'll try.
The potassium phosphate in the sports elixir must have had an adverse chemical reaction with the triglyceride compound in this web, thus working like an acid. Ha! Interesting.
Oh!
I'm terribly sorry, Master Larry. I haven't been the butler you need me to be.
No need to apologize, Alfred. I completely understand. But I need your help.
It seems we need each other's help to get out of temptation.
I don't know what happened. I just thought I need a little bit of chocolate.
Master Larry, you cannot be the superhero God wants you to be if...
If all I ever think about is chocolate. I know that now, Alfred. Yeah. Oh, thanks for your help, buddy.
And thank you for yours. But others are still in the grip of temptation. We must help free them or Bumblyburg will be doomed.
My heir, I can't do a thing with it.
You've been led into temptation by that bad apple.
That lovely apple?
I'm afraid her beauty is only skin deep.
She needs help.
Master Larry!
You can't be the mayor God wants you to be if all you think about is how you look.
That is true.
Bumblyburg is in trouble.
Oh, my goodness. Please, can you help me get out of here?
You bet I can.
My friends.
Our pleasure, Your Honor. Now we need to free Petunia. The city needs to learn the news.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bumblyburgers of all ages, the fabulous Appley's Funhouse 2 is open for business. Come on in and join the fun and frolic. We got the...
Whoever enters the funhouse stays in the funhouse.
Appley's Funhouse 2, the round-the-clock funnest place in town.
I didn't see anything about this on the news.
Come to think of it, I haven't seen anything on the news.
Petunia!
I don't think I can hold them off much longer.
I'm on the way!
Help me! How do I get out of here?
There's nothing wrong with playing video games, but you've let this video game play you!
I know! I want out!
Hold on! Let's find out what's going on out there.
Come on, folks! Hurry, hurry, hurry! It's all happening on the inside! Nothing going on out here!
Hey, who's that little worm?
Apprehend him, Master Larry! He's working for the apple!
Officer, Arrest this worm!
What's the charge?
Accomplice to temptation with intent to lead astray. Operating a giant Macintosh without a permit.
What? You can't arrest me!
And resisting arrest. Petunia, do your thing.
You got it. Okay, on me in 3, 2...
Petunia Rhubarb, coming to you live from Bumbleyburg Park. A huge, monstrous apple has been sighted here in the park. Authorities are cautioning the public not, I repeat, do not go near Apley's Funhouse. Turn away from temptation. It's a trap. Believe me, I know. Repeat, flee temptation.
What's happening? What are they doing?
All right, Bad Apple, the jig is up.
Larry Boy is back on the scene to fight the Bad Apple. His only chance to save the townspeople is to bring down the Bad Apple's web shooter.
Bad Apple, you are rotten to the core!
Go! I've got one shot to plug that web shooter.
Sorry. Whoa!
Master Larry, what are you doing? You've got to take down the giant apple.
No problem, Alfred. I'm just working on a plan.
You should use oomph.
But I am giving it everything I got.
Oh, right.
No!
Attention, everyone. I need help from all the municipal departments. Quickly, position yourselves on each of the web connections. Larry Boy needs our help.
All citizens are clear of the funhouse.
All right, everyone. Squad!
So, with the help of the municipal departments, they take down the giant apple's funhouse of temptation and save the town. The people are clear of the web of temptation.
How about that party?
My fellow citizens, we are gathered here today to commemorate the 300th anniversary of the founding of our great city of Bumbleyburg! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you our founding father, Obadiah Bumbley! We have someone else to thank for delivering our town from this terrible evil. And that, of course, is our city's great superhero, Larry Boy!
Why, thank you, dear, but I can't take the credit. Temptation is too strong for any one of us to handle alone. We need God's help and the help of the people around us, our friends, and our family.
Well put, Master Larry.
Libby, I hope you liked the show, and I hope you learned something from it. I know I did.
Larry Boy had a weakness for chocolate.
That's why I needed the help of the good friends that God gave me to keep chocolate from getting the best of me.
I fear video games might have a similar effect on our friend Libby.
Yep, there's nothing wrong with playing video games once in a while, but when they keep you from doing your homework or from helping your mom and dad around the house, they're keeping you from being the kid that God wants you to be.
You might want to ask your parents for some help with ideas on how to avoid the temptation of that ever-present video controller, or chocolate, or whatever.
Great idea, Alfred.
Just remember, God made you special.
And he loves you very much.
Goodbye!
Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode of VeggieTales and that you learned a lot from the story. Don't forget to check out VeggieTales.com, where you'll find loads of fun games, puzzles, videos, and so much more. So for me, Larry the Cucumber, and all your veggie friends, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again soon. Stay tuned for some really silly songs that'll have everyone singing along. Goodbye!
And now it's time for Silly Songs with Larry, the part of the show where Larry comes out and sings a silly song. Our curtain opens as Larry, having just finished his morning bath, is searching for his hairbrush. Having no success, Larry cries out,
"Oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where is my hairbrush? Oh, where, 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 oh, where is my hairbrush?"
Having heard his cry, Pa Grape enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Pa regains his composure and reports.
I think I saw a hairbrush back there.
Back there with my hairbrush. Back there with my hairbrush. Back there, back there, oh where, back there, oh where, oh where, back there, back there, back there. Is my hairbrush.
Having heard his joyous proclamation, Junior Asparagus enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Junior regains his composure and comments,
"Why do you need a hairbrush? You don't have any hair!"
Larry is taken aback. The thought had never occurred to him. No hair? What will this mean? What will become of him? What will become of his hairbrush? Larry wonders,
"No hair for my hairbrush. No hair for my hairbrush. No hair, 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 back there, no hair for my hairbrush."
Having heard his wonderings, Bob the Tomato enters the scene. Shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of Larry in a towel, Bob regains his composure and confesses,
"Larry, that old hairbrush of yours, well, you never use it, you don't really need it, so, well, I'm sorry, I didn't know, but I gave it to the peach, 'cause he's got hair."
Feeling a deep sense of loss, Larry stumbles back and laments,
"Not fair, oh my hairbrush, not fair, my poor hairbrush. Not fair, not fair, no hair, not fair, no wear, no hair, not fair, not fair, not fair, my little hairbrush."
Having heard his lament, the peach enters the scene. Himself in a towel, both Larry and the peach are shocked and slightly embarrassed at the sight of each other. But recognizing Larry's generosity, the peach is thankful.
"Thanks for the hairbrush.
Yes, good has been done here." The peach exits the scene. Larry smiles, but still feeling an emotional attachment for the hairbrush, calls out,
"Take care of my hairbrush. Take care, oh my hairbrush. Take care, don't dare not care. Take care, nice hair, no fair. Take care of my hairbrush."
The end.
And now it's time for Helpful Humanitarian Songs with Mr. Lunt, the part of the show where Mr. Lunt comes out and sings a helpful humanitarian song.
Well, he's a mangy or pet. If you saw him, I bet you'd walk the other way. So sad and alone, with his hair overgrown, like a stinky old toupee. But doggies have feelings, and doggies need love, and doggies like those deep-fried treats that come from up above. Oh, donuts for Penny, please give a glaze to make him smile. Thank you, ma'am, poor troubled beast. Won't you at least comfort him a while? Sir, can you spare a donut for Penny? Please help my doggy friend. Thank you, kind sir. A honey dip would really help his broken heart to mend. His broken heart to mend. Well, just look at this pup. He's brightening up. Oh, he's looking not so weak. Oh, Penny, his outlook was grim till you gave pastries to him. Oh, look, he wants to speak. Oh, doggies have feelings. And doggies need love. That's a boy. And doggies like sweet doughy treats that come from.
Ship on an ocean of joy. I just want to holler out loud. Ship ahoy! Must be around again, baby. Around, around, around.
Maybe you shouldn't have any more donuts.
No,
don't give him any more. They make him crazy.
Around,
don't give him
the joy. Just
I need a new
pet. Let's be around again, baby.
Around.
This has been Helpful Humanitarian Songs with Mr. Lunt. Tune in next time to hear Mr. Lunt say...
Don't give donuts to dogs!
One day, while he was waiting for the trolley, he had a hat,
my high silk hat.
He wore it high upon his head so proudly, a beautiful hat,
my high silk hat.
A hat like this just makes him feel so grandly. Now fancy this, and fancy that. The splendor of this hat in all its majesty.
Like a king in a royal cap. I feel so swell and handsome in my hat. I bet that others wish they had. In fact,
a hat as this, a hat as that, a hat so fine, a high so fat.
Oh, Mr. Art Bugatti, now what do you think of that?
Now his hat was not all he wore so proudly. I must, in fact, share more than that. For upon his lap a sat a treat so fondly of chocolate this
and chocolate that.
Deliciousness that makes him feel so dandy. A chocolate bliss.
A chocolate snack.
Conventions such as these are more than candy. Someone might buy a box of that.
I have my chocolate placed upon my lap. I feel so good, you just cannot top that. I have my snack, a chocolate pack of chocolate bits and chocolate that. Oh golly, Mr. Nezzer, now what do you think of that?
Upon his hat
and chocolate snack.
So beneath his hat he thought and pondered,
what should I do to save my hat?
He thought and contemplated as he perspired beneath his hat.
Upon his hat
he feared his chocolate treats would soon retire into a pool
and chocolate hat.
I won't feel grand if I take off my hat. The sun's getting hot and my hat just might go flat. My hat, it might go flat, and my sweets will melt like that. Oh, hurry, Mr. Trolley, before my dapperness goes flat.
He decided to forgo his looks so dashing to save his hat
and little snack.
So he placed the treats upon the seat beside him
and put his hat on top of that.
Oh, please,
oh, please, oh, please.
Don't anybody sit close to me.
Close to me.
Upon my hat.
My hat.
I ask if all of you can be so kindly and just stand back away from my snack. A great big squash just sat upon my hat. A great big squash just squished my hat real flat. He squashed my hat, he made it flat, he squished my snack. Oh, what a bat. Oh, tell me anybody, now what do you think of that?
A great big squash just sat upon my hat. A great big enormous squash squished his hat real flat. He squashed his hat, he made it flat.
Oh, golly! What's your name?
They've never given me a name. I've been around since show one, and I still don't have a name.
Now, what do you think?